Can you really lose weight while eating the foods that you love? Hey, I'm Jason Chaney, and thanks for signing up. So let's go ahead and dig into it. That's what we're going to talk about today. And so, you know, if you don't, you're not familiar with my story. I was someone who struggled with weight loss for many of years, especially after I left the military. I actually got to a point to where I was over 500 plus pounds, and I found myself not being able to bend down to tie my own shoes. And I remember the day like yesterday. It was me and my wife. We were getting ready. It was a typical Sunday morning. And we was about to go to our favorite diner in Arlington, Texas. And I sat on the edge of that California king bed. And I was getting dressed. And then I bent down to try to put my shoes on. And I just couldn't reach my feet. And I was like, oh, maybe my screws in my back. Because I have a spinal fusion. So like, maybe the screws in my back just got me a little stiffer. So I pulled myself more onto the bed, and then I realized, as I tried to bend down again, my stomach was a barrier stopping me from reaching my feet to put my shoes on. So that time, I was just trying to figure out, what can I do? I have to find a way to put these shoes on, and the only thing that came to my head was to call and ask my wife for help. And as she sat on the floor, asked me to kick my feet up on her legs, as she was struggling to put a size 18 Nikes on my swollen feet, all I could think in my head was like, I'm no longer a provider and protector for her. And she's now my caretaker. I have to do something. I must find a way to lose weight. I must find a way to be healthier, to be a better husband for her. And so I went on a journey, and I was doing fad diet after fad diet. I was trying everything. I mean, I tried everything from a Mediterranean diet, drinking cayenne pepper and lemonade, also doing a liquid diet. And then I went into the low carb diet also. But all of these things had the same issue. One, either they was telling me I had to restrict certain foods that I love to eat and I didn't want to get rid of them, or they were telling me not to eat so much, like watch your calories. And so I was just hungry each and every day. And I was like, there have to be a better way, and I'm going to find it. So after scouring the internet, I had finally found plant-based diet. Never heard of it, never knew it existed. And when I found out about plant-based diet, it was like, okay, you can eat all fruits and vegetables. And I started seeing a lot of people losing weight on it. So I was like, okay, let me see what I can do. Let me try it out. So I went, got into some different plant-based groups, hearing other people's stories. But the thing about it was, people were saying, oh, well, you can only eat these grains, you can only eat these things. And one, it was foods that I wasn't familiar with, so I didn't know how to cook them. I was wasting a ton of food just throwing it out because I was either overcooking it, undercooking it, or just didn't know what the heck I was doing. And then the second thing problem with it was, because it's foods I'm not familiar with, I'm spending all this time trying to figure out how to find them, overspending in specialty stores, things like that. And I was just like, wait. There have to be a simpler way to do this. And then that's when I discovered the concept I like to call your food home. And this is just the foods that you eat each and every day. And so this is how we're going to get into how you can actually lose weight with the foods you love. So the first thing you want to do is finding the foods out that you love. So take out a piece of paper and you just want to write down, what are the foods you go to? What are the foods you go to when you're stressed out? What are the foods you like to celebrate with? What are the foods you just like to have on a nice day when, hey, I got off work early, I don't feel like cooking, and I just want to relax and lounge around. So just to give you an example, for me, part of my food home is I love to eat pizza. So pizza, spaghetti, biscuits and gravy, things like that, that is part of my food home that I love. And so once you get your food home together, then the second part you want to do is you want to start switching the animal products for plant-based products. This is how you want to get the enjoy those foods still without giving them up. So if you, like for me, I tell you, I like to eat pizza. So I eat pizza with plant-based crumbles, soy crumbles on it for meat replacement, with plant-based cheese, things like that. I eat, instead of eating a double cheeseburger, I'll eat a black bean burger with plant-based cheese on it. So you're not going to give up any of the foods you love. You're just going to switch them out for animal products. And so the best way to do that is, so let's say if you put on there spaghetti, just go on Google and type in vegan spaghetti. And it's going to give you recipes. It's going to also give you different types of things you can buy that should be locally available in your area, and you'll be able to see, okay, I can use just, all I have to do is substitute the ground beef for a plant-based beef. And that's as simple as that. How does that sound for you? And so the third one is, now this is a really, really big one. And this one I did not understand when I was growing up. I had no concept of this. And it's reducing your processed oils. So I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm a Texas boy. I was deep frying everything. At the state fair, we would even deep fry Twinkies and Oreos. And I never knew the harm that I was doing to my body from it. So I'm a visual person. So here's one cup. One cup of processed oil is almost 2,000 calories. Like, this is almost 2,000 calories you're putting in your body whenever you're deep frying something. And the truth is, how many of us just do one cup of oil that we're deep frying? If it was me, I just did the old look method. Until almost all the bottle was into the pot, I wasn't ready to start deep frying anything. And so one of the ways you can reduce your processed oils is actually by getting a simple appliance in your home called an air fryer. These are really good. They use high heat induction without going into all the details of it. But it's a way to actually cook your food and deep fry, still get you the crunch on your French fries and things like that. And you can use just maybe a tablespoon of oil. Now, going from over a cup to a tablespoon, that's a very drastic reduction of how much processed oil you're putting in your diet. And your belly is going to thank you in the long run. And so the last thing you want to do is eat until you're full. Now, this may sound simple, but this is a lot different. Remember, we're going from those 2,000 empty calories here to actually eating the calories that your body needs, eating the food that your body needs. So eat until you're full. If you're hungry, eat. It's all plant-based, so it's not going to hurt you. So eat until you're full and make sure you do that. So just to go over those again, the first thing we're going to do is finding the foods you love. So make sure you write your list out on find the foods that you love. Use stressful situations, foods you want to go to when you want to celebrate, foods you want to go to just on those days you just want to relax and you don't feel like cooking. Those are, so that way you're planned for no matter what happens. Second one is switching out animal products for plant products. This can be as simple as switching out ground beef to a plant-based soy crumble beef, or going from butter to a plant-based margarine. Those are just easy ways. Third one is reducing your processed oil. If you say, hey, Jason, I still need those my French fries and stuff like that, then invest in an air fryer. Your health is going to love it, your stomach is going to love it, and your weight is going to show you as it's reducing off. So make sure you're reducing your processed oils. And the last one is eat until you're full. Because you're on a plant-based diet, you're eating nutrient-dense food, so you want to make sure you're eating until you're full. And so I hope that helped you. Ciao.